Morning, and welcome to our service here at St. Mary's on Remembrance Sunday. Just have one intimation, and that is that in 2 weeks' time, 28th of November, it's the first Sunday in Advent, we are also going to celebrate communion as part of our worship. And this is the first time that we have had communion in the sanctuary for quite some time, so it will feel a little bit different. We're going to be using friendship cups to serve the elements of bread and wine, so you will receive that as you come in the door for the start of that service. So it will still feel very different from normal, but it will be lovely to be able to celebrate communion together once again. If you are watching our service on that day online and you're at home, then you may want to have your own elements of bread and wine ready for that part of the service. There is also a short note which you will receive in print as you're leaving church this morning that just gives you a bit more detail around those arrangements. And it's with sadness this morning that I intimate the death of Mrs. Connie Walls of Burns Court in Kirkintilloch. That funeral service is on Tuesday the 16th of November. It's at 1 o'clock, and that is at Falkirk Crematorium. And our thoughts and prayers are with the family at this difficult time.
In faith, we come to be silent and commemorate all that has been lost. In hope, we come to remember and look to honour the way of peace. In love, we come to worship God who is with us and calls us to follow him today, tomorrow, and always. Let us worship God in our opening praise, standing together and singing hymn 161, O God, our help in ages past.
Thank you.
The psalmist says God is our refuge and our strength, a timely help in trouble. Let us pray. Eternal God, our help and home, on this day you have called us together to make space for silence to remember. To remember in wars of the past and wars of the present, you are God who desires justice and peace. To remember that in a broken world, full of damaged lives and shattered dreams, you are God whose purposes for us all are good. To remember that in a world where many gave all and continue to do so, you are God who has given us your Son and made us your friends. And to remember, in the wrong we should not have done but have, and the right we should have done but have not, you are God who forgives us. We know that you remember us. Help us to remember you. And as we ready ourselves to fall silent and remember this day, pour peace into our hearts, minds, and spirits, that we might choose to shape a silence that folds both heaven and earth into a single harmony, and remember together our calling to be people who walk with you the path of peace. Eternal God, our help and our home, may it increasingly be so, for we ask it all in the name of Jesus. Amen. And so let us stand together and remember. Let us stand. Let us remember the kindness of God and his favor to us in our time of need. Let us remember the courage, the devotion to duty and the self-sacrifice of the men and women in our armed forces, the toil, the endurance and suffering of those who were not in uniform, the support of those who sent us help from afar or came and stood by our side. Let us remember those who were wounded in the fight, those who perished in air raids at home, those who fell in battle and are buried at sea or in some corner of a foreign field, and especially those whom we have known and loved, whose place is forever in our hearts. Let us remember those who were our enemies, whose homes and hearts are as bereft as ours, whose dead also lie in a living tomb of everlasting remembrance. Let us remember those who came back, those whose lives still bear the scars of war, those who lost sight or limbs or reason, those who lost faith in God and hope for humanity. Let us remember the continuing grace of God, whose love holds all souls in life, and to whom none is dead, but are alive forever. They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them. In memory of those who died, may we be better men and women, boys and girls, and in gratitude to God, may we live as those who are not their own, but who are bought with a price, and seek to be peacemakers in this world. Amen. Please be seated. Good morning, girls and boy. You could have heard a pin drop in here a minute ago, couldn't you? Well, and I didn't see any of this going on. Shh, none of that. You were absolutely fantastic. Thank you. Why were we being silent and remembering this morning? Can anybody tell me why? Grace. That's right. It's Remembrance Sunday, Poppy Sunday, the day when we remember all those who died in active service in World War I and World War II and all conflicts since. We remember those who died, and we remember just how awful war is and how we should live our lives in ways that seek to bring peace to one another. And you know, me doing that there, shh, it makes me think that our hands speak. We can say so much with just our hands. For instance, if I was to do that, let's see you pointing, what am I doing? I'm giving it away, haven't I? I'm pointing. What if I'm clapping my hands? Let's see you clap your hands. Yeah. What are we saying when we're clapping our hands? Thanks, Elizabeth. Well done. Yeah. What if I go, am I happy? Yeah. Am I? Well, I could be. I could be cheering my team on, I suppose. I could be. Ah, I'm really angry. Let's see your fists in the air. Ah, yeah. What if I do that? Someone's been naughty, eh? Absolutely. And I think there was one more, if can I remember what it was. My memory's not what it used to be. Can you think of any? Oh, yes. What if I do that? I'm waving, let's see you wave. So you can be saying hello, or you can say bye. You can be waving goodbye. Our hands speak. What if I were to come up and I was to shake your hands? What might I be saying there? Hello. That was the initial sign for I come in peace, giving your hand in friendship. And that's a really nice thing to do. And over this last wee while, we've not been able to do that. We've been using our elbows instead, or maybe doing some fist pumps. Yeah. And I would love to be able for everybody today to turn round and to share the peace. Now, we can't use our hands, but there was another sign that I came across during the week. You could do your elbow if you're sitting close enough to somebody, but there's another one. And you put your hands across your heart, and you look at someone in the eye, and you say, peace be with you. Yeah. Peace be with you. Do you think we could all turn to one another, and we can share that sign of peace one with another this morning? Peace be with you. Thank you. Well, our hands really do speak, and our next hymn this morning is one that talks about a time when people will stand hand in hand in friendship. But that's God's hope and that's God's dream for the world. And it's 710, I have a dream, a man once said.
Thank you.
Bible readings we're about to hear just now are all about uniting us in peace. It talks about swords into ploughs, spears into pruning knives, and everyone living in harmony. And to that end, young church, I've got some colourful pipe cleaners with me this morning. And as we listen to our Bible reading, I wondered if you could make something that is useful, something that is beautiful and lovely, that speaks about peace and not war. Okay, a bit tricky to get out, so take some there. Sorry, Hugh. Let's all listen for God's word.
Thank you. This morning's first reading is from the Old Testament, Micah chapter 4, which can be found at approximately page 901 of the Good News Bible. The Lord's universal reign of peace. In days to come, the mountain where the temple stands will be the highest one of all, towering above all the hills. Many nations will come streaming to it. And the people will go, will say, let us go up the hill of the Lord to the temple of Israel's God. He will teach us what he wants us to do. We will walk in the paths he has chosen. For the Lord's teaching comes from Jerusalem. From Zion, he speaks to his people. He will settle disputes among the nations, among the great powers near and far. They will hammer their swords into ploughs, and their spears into pruning knives. Nations will never again go to war, never prepare for battle again. Everyone will live in peace among his own vineyards and fig trees, and no one will make him afraid. The Lord Almighty has promised this. The second reading is from the New Testament, 1 Peter at chapter 3, suffering for doing right. To conclude, you must all have the same attitude and the same feelings. Love one another as brothers and sisters, and be kind and humble with one another. Do not pay back evil with evil, or cursing with cursing. Instead, pay back with a blessing, because a blessing is what God promised to give you when he called you. As the scripture says, whoever wants to enjoy life and wishes to see good times must keep from speaking evil and stop telling lies. They must turn away from the evil and do good. They must strive for peace with all their heart, for the Lord watches over the righteous and listens to their prayers, but he opposes those who do evil. Amen, and may the Lord give his blessing to this reading from his holy word.
Thank you, Hugh. We know that when World War I broke out way back in 1914, there was a bit of a romantic notion about war. It started in August, and many believed that it would be over by Christmas. And so there was a rush of young men signing up to serve their country, lest they miss out on the opportunity. However, as time passed and Christmas came and went, it soon became clear that war was anything but romantic. In his poem, Waste, the Padre Geoffrey Stuart Kennedy had this to say: waste of muscle, waste of brain, waste of patience, waste of pain, waste of manhood, waste of health, waste of beauty, waste of wealth, waste of blood and waste of tears, waste of youth's most precious years, waste of ways the saints have trod, waste of glory, waste of God. War. War is awful, isn't it? It is a destructive and an empty thing, a little bit like the bag that I have got here before me this morning. Empty. An empty bag. War, well, it destroys all sorts of things, doesn't it? Crops and communities, livelihoods and relationships and life itself. It's empty. It is wasteful and destructive. But you and me know that war does not have the final words, does it? Because we know that at the end of World War I, something happened. That in the midst of the mud and the brokenness and the barrenness, when it felt as if everything was hopeless and desperate and lost, something amazing happened. Why don't you come and show us what happened? That in the midst of that wastefulness, when it felt as if everything was hopeless, something began to grow. Something fragile and beautiful, red in color that reminded us of the cost of war in those fields, but not just one, thousands upon thousands of poppies. Reach your hand in. Could you put them down on top of the grass? Yeah. Thousands and thousands of red poppies filled the fields in Flanders. Signs that hope is real and that life can grow even from the very worst of times. Thank you. Poppies, it reminds us of the resilience of life, of faith and hope and love, the tenacity of love, the cost of love, and the way to peace. And you and I know that the ways to peace are not forged by magic tricks, can't be conjured out of a bag, even if we wish that that was so. No, the way to peace, as we have just been reminded, is a hard road. It is in many ways the road less travelled, because it means turning away in day out and day in from those things that hurt and wound us, and turning towards all that is good, striving for peace with all our hearts, reaching out our hands in friendship or our elbows when it's easier to throw our hands up and walk away, choosing to retaliate, not with a wrong word or action, but instead with a word of peace, with a word of forgiveness. And when that is too difficult, too big for us to even imagine or comprehend, then we seek the peace of God and trust that one day God will make all things new. It's hard work, the road to peace, but it's the only one in the end that brings life and healing and wholeness. Today, as we remember the cost of war, may we hold on to the hope that is stronger than despair, and remember in and through it all, God loves us. God is with us. And longs for the day when everyone will live in peace. Amen. We're going to sing again, 528, Make Me a Channel of Your Peace. Mm-hmm. How are you getting on? Have you made something? Need a bit more time? I'll take that as a yes. They're all frantically working away, so I'll leave that to you just now. Make me a channel of your peace. Peace is where the likes of today leads our thoughts. And I share with you now the words of a hymn called Say No to Peace. Say no to peace. If what they mean by peace is the quiet misery of hunger, the frozen stillness of fear, the silence of broken spirits, the unborn hopes of the oppressed. Tell them that peace is the shouting of children at play, the babble of tongues set free, the thunder of dancing feet, and a father's voice singing. Say no to peace, if what they mean by peace is a rampart of gleaming missiles, the arming of distant wars, money at ease in its castle, and grateful poor at the gate. Tell them that peace is the hauling down of flags, the forging of guns into ploughs, the giving of fields to the landless, and hunger a fading dream. If things were different today, at this point I'd be asking David to play and inviting you forward to lay down your poppy as another act of remembrance and a symbol of your commitment to walk the way of peace. You can't do that today, but our young church can do it on our behalf. And so as they come forward to lay their poppies down on the grass, I invite everyone here to stand and to rededicate ourselves to that way of peace. And when you hear the questions, if you feel that you're able to do so, if you answer, we will. Let's stand together. Friends, will you strive for all that makes for peace? We will. Will you seek to heal the wounds of war and division? Will you work for a just future for all humanity? We will. Thank you. Please be seated. Are you all down now? Are you ready to show me what you've been up to? Started something we can't finish. Isn't that true of a lot of things in life? Well, do you know what? You can have a wee bit extra time because we are going to bow our heads now in prayer and offer our prayers for others this day. Let us pray. Loving God, on this day of remembrance, when we acknowledge the sacrifice and the cost of war, we pray for all members of the armed forces who are in active service, remembering family, friends, and all who pray for their safe return. We pray for those who have been injured in body and mind, and disabled through war, for those who have lost homes and security through conflict, and all who have lost relatives and friends, for those who face danger and take risks for peace, governments and leaders, United Nations forces and diplomats, pressure groups and ordinary people, and for all those children, men and women caught up in current fighting in places like Israel, Afghanistan, and Syria, to name but a few. We pray for those fleeing scared, refugees, and all those in need of help and aid. Lord, where pain still overwhelms, bring healing. Where hearts are still breaking, bring comfort. Where people are still oppressed, bring liberation. Where communities are still victimized, bring justice. Where lives are still crushed, bring hope. Where evil is perpetrated, bring repentance. Where war still devastates, bring a truce. Through the courage, leadership, and witness of all people, leaders, sovereigns, diplomats, people of all faiths and none, willing to walk the hard path of reconciliation and peace. And Lord, as we remember today, so we also remember those in our midst who are grieving. We pray for the family of Connie Walls. And we pray, Lord, for the family of Provost Alan Brown and for all those who are sad and heartbroken today. Lord, in the silence, hear our prayer. Lord God, make us your church, peacemakers and peacekeepers in all our living. For we ask it all in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Your time's up. Who wants to show me what you've made? Great. Let's see. Oh, that's lovely. Is that a tree? Yeah, look at that. A beautiful tree. A wonderful sign of life there. Nice and healthy and green. Thank you for that. What else have we got? What have we got here?
Puppets.
Puppets. Is that a wee person?
Yeah.
Absolutely. A nice wee person there. Nice and colourful. Thank you for that. Anybody else? I see a lovely, is that a love heart? Fantastic. There you are. Perfect symbol for today, isn't it? Love. A reminder to love one another as we remember the sacrifice of those who gave it all. And I see lovely flowers down here. Can I borrow that for a wee minute? Thank you. What a beautiful flower. There you are, a wonderful sign of life as well. Yours too. Thank you. Oh, you've been very creative, Louise. We've got a bumblebee as well. Fantastic. Thank you for all of those. A reminder from our Bible passage to turn things that are hurtful and nasty into things that are useful and loving. Friends, we're going to stand together and we're going to sing our final hymn, and that is 706, For the Healing of the Nations. Let us pray. God, grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to all people peace and concord, and to us all life everlasting as we come and go in peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you all. Anthem.